She's always been wanting the attention of everybody. She was center stage with everything.
All the children of the world.
I always told him from the time she was young with her personality, I said she's either going to be successful in some sort of either entertainment or we're going to be supporting her the rest of her life.
Mommy.
What?
Can we go videotape my room? What you did to it?
Oh, yeah.
I'm Bob.
I'm Angela, and our daughter is WWE superstar Alexa Bliss.
Lexi, do something cute for the camera.
Since the time that she was born, of course, she had to make a grand entrance. She was a month early.
We had her young. I was 17, she was 18. So when we started, it was a struggle. You know, at the beginning, we got, you know, the smallest apartment we could get and pinched every penny to be able to pay bills. But later on, we started a business that ended up being fairly successful. So then we were able to provide more. We moved to a suburb in Columbus and, you know, out of the small apartment in the city.
Ohio will always be home.
My bedroom, that window up there. This is the driving range. Me and my friends would go out and play flashlight tag or hit the golf balls back the other direction. Terrible golfer, by the way. Terrible.
I see you.
I see you too.
She was involved in a lot of different sports. We always tried to keep her involved so that she had something to do after school on the weekends. So she started off when she was younger in gymnastics. She was watching TV when she was four and it was the Olympics were on, and she's standing in front of the TV with her little hand on her hip telling us, oh, that looks easy.
The relationship with my parents I've always had, we've always been really close, basically giving me all the tools I needed to succeed. My dad coached my softball team. They're like, you know what, you need to learn to defend yourself, so we're gonna put you in kickboxing. So then I did kickboxing, and then that transitioned into all-star cheer. I got to go to Worlds for competitive all-star cheerleading, and that's like the Olympics of cheerleading. And so we all went, and it was in Disney World. And Disney has always been, you know, a special place in my heart. Every year we've gone since I was 3 years old. It was our family thing that we always did. And so just kind of having those moments and knowing that it's like little mini family vacations. It's really cool.
You were so proud of your teeth being gone.
I'm doing the Miss America wave.
Look how proud you are of it. You're like making sure that the top and bottom are showing.
Yeah, my mom is definitely more than just my mom. I mean, growing up, she was super strict. She wasn't my friend, and she used to tell me that all the time. She'd be like, I'm not your friend, I'm your mother. But then the older I got, you know, I kind of grew up with her. We kind of grew up together because she had me at such a young age, and now she's my best friend, and I don't know what I would do without her.
Do you remember when I texted you?
Hold on, sorry, I got, like, something on my lip.
You're the worst! No, it's not.
Well, I just bit it off, but it was sticking up, and I felt it hit my other lip.
Anyways.
She had battled an eating disorder since she was 15 years old. We had almost lost her at one point.
They told me that we were going to church. So we get in the car, and I think we're going to church, and we actually show up at the hospital. They take my vital signs, and they immediately tell my parents, they're like, we're gonna keep your daughter with or without your consent because she's 24 hours away from dying. You know, I'm terrified. It's just very, it was a very scary moment, and my mom just stood behind me, and she's like, I'm so sorry, but we have to do this. And she's like, you're gonna stay here for a while, and you're gonna get better. And after, you know, weeks and weeks and weeks in the hospital, it wasn't really for the actual eating disorder. It was because I was having issues, you know, with my heart rate coming back and all this stuff. And I just remember my parents were there every single day, and my mom slept in the hospital on the couch. And she would just sit with me and talk to me and tell me how proud of me she was every bite that I would take and just help me really, you know, come back into who I really was and not let this, you know, take control of me, because they told me that, you know, 1 in 4 people die of anorexia, and I was closest to that one. My mom just looks at me and she goes, I don't want your life to amount to a statistic. You're gonna be that person that passes away from this and people will learn from your mistakes. And she said, do you really want your life to be that? Do you want to be a statistic? And then that's kind of that moment where I was just like, oh crap, you know, like, no.
All right, we're here at my old cheer gym where I basically lived Step One All-Stars in Columbus.
Yeah. It's kind of bigger than the last time you were here, right?
Yeah. Yeah, so Stephanie has known me since middle school. She was there for when I was doing All-Star cheer. She was there for me through my eating disorder.
Is true.
Yes. She actually kicked me off the team.
I did actually kick you off the team. That is a true statement. I had to be the tough one that would say, no, you can only come back when you hit this weight, or you can only come back when you're able to do this skill, which were easy skills for her, but became very challenging skills for her because of the things that she had gone through health-wise. Well, of course, our girl bounced back perfectly, and she got to compete her senior year with us and go to the World Championship, where she found herself on the cover of American Cheerleader magazine and just made us overall super proud.
When she went away to college, the eating disorder came back. So she went and got treatment and was hospitalized. And when she came out, you know, she kept saying, I know that I need to gain weight, but I need to do it in a healthy way. Well, when she was younger, we had friends that were bodybuilders, and she had always said that she wanted to do that.
So I had trained with my trainer, Natalie Callen, since I was 15 years old. And I went to her and I said, I need help. You know, that's probably like the hardest thing you could ever ask somebody, like, I need help. She got me in touch with her colleague, Mike Davies, and they sat me down and they said, okay, 5 weeks there's a show. There's a Natural Ohio show.
You're either gonna gain the weight and have muscle and get out there and do well, or you're gonna go out there stick thin and embarrass yourself, but you're getting on that stage.
And I ended up taking first place in my class and then first place all around. Ended up becoming one of the youngest pros to get a pro card. And I didn't necessarily really wanted to keep competing pro, but I just really wanted a pro card and just be like, yeah, did it.
Mom, I know what I'm going to do now. She said, just hear me out. I'm trying out for the WWE, and I think my exact words may have been, the hell you are.
I liked watching wrestling because I really thought it was very intriguing. Rey Mysterio, he really caught my eye because his, you know, wrestling style, which was lucha, it reminded me of gymnastics because he was like flipping around and doing all these really cool moves, and I naturally gravitated towards that. I remember going on WWE.com, and then that's when I found the link. You want to be a WWE superstar? And I said, yes, I do. So I clicked on it and paid to have a video made, sent that in, and just kind of hoped for the best.
I figured if she wanted to do it, she could figure it out and get it done. I don't think she was too happy about it.
No. Girls like China, Lexi, China. You cannot stand in a ring with China. She was like, Mom, you know, I've done so many sports. It's athletics. I can do this.
And I was signed and moved to Orlando. You know, my family was moving to Florida at the same time, coincidentally, and it kind of sped up the process of us all moving down to Florida.
As I mentioned before, I owned a business, and we had always thought about moving to Florida once I sold the business, so it kind of worked out and it made sense to make that move.
There was no way my kid was moving to another state without us. It was very, very overwhelming at first. She came in, you know, the new girl that didn't have wrestling experience.
I came home and I would cry and I said, this isn't for me. I can't, it's so hard.
the girls that I'm with, they're so good.
I would just tell her, you know, Lex, look what you've done in gymnastics, look what you've done in cheerleading, look what you've done in bodybuilding. All of those things, when you decided that you loved it and you wanted to be the best, you worked. He said, this is no different. You will be able to do exactly what you've done in every other sport.
Me and my mom is kind of really what we bonded over. I felt like I really needed her support because I didn't know what I was getting myself into.
It was one of those things that, you know, I kind of ended up being her biggest cheerleader through this, even though I was the one absolutely against it in the beginning.
When I'm around, life is bliss.
That's our Lex.
Yeah. I still am highly obsessed with things that are sparkly. It is what it is.
Every time she come out, I just smile.
Enzo and Cass appear to be on their way to capturing the NXT Tag Team Championship. It's Alexa Bliss! Alexa Bliss grabbing hold of Enzo from the top rope.
Yep, most hated. Growing up, she's always been so dramatic. So I felt like once she actually got to come out of who she is and feel like that she had more freedom to kind of do things that aren't her.
How dare you?
I knew that eventually she would just, she would do well. I knew it.
This is the WWE Draft, and 6 draft picks will be made off the NXT roster.
My daughter, I'm like, oh yeah, she definitely should be one of them. And Lexi's like, Mom, there's only 6. Don't get your hopes up. She's like, but I'm really hopeful too, you know?
On SmackDown, let's see what we got on deck. Alexa Bliss from NXT.
Very impressive in the women's division in NXT. I think this is just what she needs for her career.
I was an emotional wreck because I was so happy and I just wanted to hug her so bad in that moment because I know how hard she worked to get there.
Emotional side of me gone. The women of SmackDown better get ready because I may be small, but I am fierce.
Our favorite musical is Legally Blonde. And there's this part and it says, hey, Mom, that's my name in black and white. Your daughter must be doing something right. And she sent me that picture with that quote, and she said, that's my name in blue and white. Your daughter's doing something right. And I lost it.
I mean, there was times, you know, I was thinking that maybe this isn't for me. I was getting frustrated. I was emotional. And if it weren't for my parents telling me, you know, you can do this, and pushing me, even from when I was little.
Go, Lex, you can do it.
My friends used to tell them, you know, you're wasting your money. You're wasting your money having her do gymnastics, you're wasting your money having her do cheer, bodybuilding, all this stuff, but it's all led me to where I am today.
You're gonna cut a promo on how I'm gonna beat Becky at TLC for the SmackDown Women's title.
This is very intimidating.
It is, right? But you have to play to this camera right here.
Oh, Miss Becky Lynch, your days with my daughter's title are numbered.
And just like that, we have a new SmackDown Women's Champion. Her name is Alexa Bliss.
Everything that we had gone through, whether it was in gymnastics, cheer, my eating disorder, you know, and my parents saying to me, you know, what are you gonna do with your life? Do you wanna be a statistic or do you wanna make something of your life? And the fact that they were able to be here for one of my biggest accomplishments in my career, it all makes up for it now. I can't even put it into words. It's great.
It didn't surprise me she was able to do it because she'd always been able to kind of accomplish anything she set her mind to. She was 110% in it.
I feel she deserves everything that she gets because I saw the struggle and I saw her work so hard. And, you know, coming in without that background and having to come from behind,
to get to where she is, I'm so proud of her.
Smile for real.
I can't help it. My awkward smile.